Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're at the Keefe Tech Pool. My name is Ross Annenberg.
And my name is John Belcher.
And John and I are going to be announcing this evening the meet between Hopkinton and Norwell, Massachusetts, Norwell High School, that is. It'll be a girls and boys meet. And to start off the meet, I believe we start with the 200 medley relay. Would you like to tell us what the 200 medley relay is?
Yeah, the 200 medley relay is 50 yards per swimmer, different strokes for each lap.
So we have, as he's described to you, we have the backstroke, breaststroke, butterfly, freestyle. And those four are maybe in succession, and I'll find out in a second on that one. To start,
you're talking about the order?
Or? Yeah.
Yeah, I believe that's the order. Yeah.
The order, and we have, it's a medley relay, starting it off with Julia, Tiana, Rachel, and Emily. In the second tier, we have Grace, Abby, Emily, and Olivia. In the third tier, we have Logan, Mallory, Stephanie, and Caitlin. And Grace and Abby, Grace, Abby, Emily are in lane four, Julia, Tiana, Rachel, and Emily are in lane four. Grace, Abby, Emily are in lane two. Logan, Mallory, Stephanie are in lane, and Caitlin are in lane six.
Yeah, and I just mentioned here, Ross, from the viewer's perspective, the lanes are the one closest to the bottom of the screen would be lane one, and then two, three, four, five, and six.
That is correct. Yes. Thank you. Which one is your daughter?
My daughter is Bridget Belcher, okay. And I'm not sure she's in this event tonight, but she will. We'll be seeing her a little later.
And my daughter is a diver, so we won't see her till we get to break. We're here high above in the stands. It seems like it's a capacity crowd. Admission was free, so everybody was here early. And right now they're 3-0, and we're ready to start. And the backstroke, they start off. Everybody is competing pretty vigorously for the first leg of it. It's a 50 yards for each competitor. It looks like the Norwell kids are tied with lane four and five, or right on each other's heels, with lane three coming in third. Two Hopkinton girls are in second and third, potentially first and third, and they're off. How's your swimming skills?
Swam a little bit in high school and haven't swam much since.
Other than recreational?
Recreational swimmer, yeah.
As they go, the second tier, looks like the Norwell young lady is...
Yeah, the breaststroke is the defining swim in this race. Breaststroke, the fastest breaststroke, generally will come ahead.
And as the butterfly comes into focus, Norwell's in first. Hopkinton is in second. Norwell's in third. Hopkinton is in fourth. Fifth and sixth are Hopkinton and Norwell, respectively. And the last leg, and looks like Norwell, foreseeing any catastrophic event, looks like Norwell will take first place.
It's going to be a fight for third. Lane two and lane three.
Completes the first, Hopkinton two, Norwell three, and Hopkinton four, as we wait for the final swimmers to complete their race. Well, not a good way to start out the medley relay, but they did take second and fourth. Just not enough points to overcome the first and third.
Yep.
As we go right into the second event, first event for the boys, we have Paul, Sam, Jake in lane four, Kyle, Justin, Trevor, and Aaron in lane two. It seems that we have a brother combination, Paul Richardson and Sam Richardson. I'm not familiar with them. My daughter used to swim, so I was more familiar with the swimmers, but now I'm more familiar with the divers.
There you go. And I don't know any of the names, actually, so.
And Norwell, for all you people that live in Metro West, is on the South Shore, so they are coming a good distance, probably about an hour plus. And as you see Coach King circulating, he's pretty active with his orange garb and his dark shorts. He will be looking around to find somebody to speak with or to compliment or to encourage. Well, looks like we're going to do a secondary race here. These are non-point total races, just more for the kids' experience. And as that starts to compete with, that's Caitlin, Leah, Sierra, and Amanda. Then we have Megan, Ashley, Kylie, and Julia in the respective lanes. And again, as you see, the Hopkinton students, their teammates are all cheering the girls on. That's a big plus in Coach King's world. You'll see that during the course of the year. Coach King is big on sportsmanship and encouragement. Scoring for today's meet, first place for relays is 8 points, second place is 4 points, third place is 2 points. So as we speak right now, unofficially, it's 10-4. Kids are cheering around, they're waiting for the boys to compete. This is a good experience for the young women who are competing during vacation week, so it gives them an opportunity to be a part of the team. In Hopkinton, parents are full of volunteers. As you can see, Mr. David Franklin is on the scoring table with Mrs. Gorgle, and Lynn Annenberg has taken photographs with other parents doing the timing. Official part of the first relay. And we'll notice that Hopkinton parents are wearing their Hopkinton Hillers shirts. That was part of a fundraising expedition, I think. You know any members of the boys team?
A couple of sophomore boys. I don't see them out there right now, but
as this is an out of league meet, I believe this is a dual meet, so it's boys versus boys, girls versus girls. and they're off. Paul, Sam, and Jake. So Paul Richardson is taking the first leg in the 200 medley relay as a backstroker.
Man, this kid from Norwell can swim, the backstroker there.
Looks like they have a very robust team. Let's see if Hopkinton can make up some ground or
make yeah, it's up gonna, some. It's going to be hard to beat that one, I think, right there.
Make up some water. Pulling away with, you thought that there was a fast backstroker and a fast breaststroker? Welcome to the butterfly.
Looks like there's going to be a fight for second. Lane two and three. And Hopkinton is ahead now in second place.
Jake Glover is going to complete the field. Hopefully he'll be able to round it out and get it over, get the second place finish. So
he's going to be pressed on this one.
It's coming down to the wire. Jake and Norwell, and Jake takes home the silver medal.
Very nice, consistent swim there for Jake.
It looks like Norwell has a team that needs to be reckoned with, at least on the first two events, the two individual medley relays, 200. And unofficially, Norwell has taken first and third place.
Now, how does it go? There'll be a separate score for the boys and the girls in this
right.
race?
Yes, exactly. So it'll be like the boys don't exist or the girls don't exist. It'll just be an individual team event per gender.
But you won't have boys swimming against girls?
Not in this one, no. Yep. Only league events.
Okay. I kind of like it when the boys swim against the girls. It makes the girls swim faster, and I have a daughter. So
there you go. And the second event we have is the 200 freestyle, competing for Hopkinton, Lydia Franklin in lane four, and I believe a relative of yours,
yep.
Bridget Belger in lane two, and Kelly.
Now I don't
Kelly,
see.
Kelly Kay, we'll call her.
Yeah, it looks like
Kay
this
Hone,
is, looks like they're.
Is.
Yeah. It looks like Bridget's in lane three. Oh, no, that's Lydia. She must be in lane six.
Yeah, it looks like they're in lane three. It has it weird. It has it set up differently.
Yep. Once again, Norwell is in the lead. But they're starting to pace themselves.
This is eight laps of the pool, 25 yards each. It's comparable to a 400 yard track. Once around the track, it gives you ability to do some splits to see if you have an ability to increase your velocity, how fast you can go. Apparently we're in for a long night if this is the way it's going to handle.
Yeah, Looks like right now it's Norwell in first, Bridget Belger in second, and Lydia Franklin in third.
Is this your daughter's best event?
I wouldn't say that, but I'll never be quoted on what her best event is.
Gotcha. I don't have that worry.
Yeah, your daughter's a diver, right?
Yeah, very simple.
Yes.
First place is Norwell. Second place is Bridget. Third place is Lydia. If we could take second and third, it'll at least give us.
And this is the bell laps here now, right?
It is the bell lap. This is the seventh turnaround, I believe. First place is six, second place is four, third place is three, two, and one, respectively. And it looks like, barring a...
Now, this is an interesting thing. Lydia and Bridget are friends, and I wonder what's going through their minds. It's coming down to the wire here.
And I think Hopkinton came in second and third.
Yep. And once again, Norwell was way ahead for number one.
As we go on to the boys 200 freestyle, we have Brad, Zach, and Colin in 4, 2, and 6 respectively, but it looks like they were going in 1, 3, and 5. So as I look at the sheet that's been given to me, I may believe it may be an error, but we'll, as we go along, we'll figure things out. And the girls take a sort of a victory lap, or what's called a wind down, so they can get out of the pool so the boys can start, but they'll get out of the other side of the pool. People are trickling in. Looks like there's a lot of people coming to the event. Some alumni are here, looks like, during the school vacation, college students. A lot of people look happy from their Christmas feast. Talked about in the individual medley relay, apparently they have, Norway has come to compete today.
It seems like that's the case. Right now it's first and second, Norwell, Hopkinton third, with a lot of race to go. You know, in a race like this, you hope that the swimmer burns himself out in the first two or three laps. Haven't seen that tonight.
Yeah, that's probably not going to happen. This hot Norwell swimmer seems to be well-versed in how to breathe properly and how to stroke it out. So it looks like he's way ahead of the game.
Ross, you're like the mayor of the swim team over here. I see you waving at everybody. And
well, alumni coming in, four-year swimmer, diver Renee Saloy.
Oh, I remember her well. Now, here we go. We got the Norwell swimmer in first, I think, and... Hillers are in second and third, but it's a close race for third. And that's the bad sign. The Norwell swimmer is finishing. All right. It looks like we're going to get a second and third here.
Actually, we're...
Oh, no, right. I'm sorry. I missed
okay.
that up.
That's all right. Yeah, yeah. He snuck behind us in lane two. So we have unofficially Norwell 1 and Norwell 2. And it looks like Hopkinton will take third, fourth, and will not be in the points.
So they, in that race, because it's individual event, Norwell got 10 points and Hillers get 6. Or, no, 11 and 5.
11 and 5,
yeah,
correct.
Yeah, okay.
As we go on to the IM, we have Abby, Olivia, and Logan in lanes 1, 3, and 5, respectively. We're hoping for a better effort here on the IM, but if it's any foreshadowing of how fast the young women and young men from Norwell are, this is going to be a long evening.
Yeah, I'm hoping that the girls are coming off their break in a little better shape than the boys.
Well, they get right back up to the plate. I think they have a meet on Wednesday.
Yep.
So there's no time for diddly-dallying. And they're off again. These are the individually medley. It's a little different relay than the IM individual. You have the breaststroke first. Then you go with the back, I believe. Then butterfly first, back, then breast, and then you complete with the freestyle to close out the event. And again, it's been a common theme. Norwell's in first and second place coming into the backstroke.
Yeah, I still feel like Olivia can make this happen.
That's what we're hoping for.
That turn is tough. The backstroke turn.
Yes, absolutely. Excuse me.
All right. It's like very close here, coming off of the backstroke.
Come on, Hopkinton, keep it going. It's neck and neck, 2, 3, and 4. Olivia's right in between them both. She's got them both in her sights.
The power's out. It looks like the power's out.
Testing. Testing.
There used to be a light on here, I don't know. I'm getting nothing, right? No.
Can you hear me?
No. Can you hear me? Yeah? Okay. I can't hear anything.
Testing.
Nothing. Once again, Norwell, first place. Hopkinton, second.
Testing,
Norwell,
testing.
Third. I'm getting nothing. Okay. Okay, from the scorers table, after two events, girls 18-12, Norwell. Boys, 21-9, Norwell.
Diving as the pool judges will be sitting down shortly, you will hear from the scoring and the announcing from the Hopkinton individual.
Jack from Hopkinton. John from Hopkinton.
It doesn't look like they'll have any divers, so it looks like that there'll be more than three girls and three boys competing, but only three official. Again, it's sort of like a second heat, giving the divers experience in front of the capacity crowd. And once we get the hang of it, we'll go ahead and give you the scoring for each individual dive as the judge is giving the instructions to the divers. Make sure that they all have a level playing field. You'll hear the numbers that the announcer suggests, and then they'll go along with the degree of difficulty. Combine that with three judges, three scorers, and then they do a mathematical formula. Lowest dive you can get is a 3 as long as you compete it, and the highest is a 10. So that was a pretty decent dive. Just to give the unofficial total, girls are down 34-28, and the boys are down 40-22. So if everything goes to course, they'll pick up 13. And this is the first official event for Alyssa Annenberg, my daughter. As she does an inward dive. Maddie Stouse. As Maddie and Lissy compete. And the third official diver is Allie Morrow, former gymnast, who's just competing for the first time this year. As she stretches out. This is Jack Mack, officially known as John McDonald, but Jack Mack is his stage name. And this is Sean, I'm not sure what his last name is. As we discussed before, this is our Swiss Army knife veteran, Aaron, who's competing as a diver, and then he'll transform into a swimmer after this is over. And this is Reese Donahue, all scholastic, on his way to Division I University of Massachusetts at Amherst as a collegiate diver. Very consistent diver.
the mark. Again, as you watch the dives, sometimes you see the girls overextending themselves. Nice dive. As you'll notice, Maddie and Alyssa are going toe-to-toe as teammates, but also as trying to qualify for the states with individual dives. And that was Allie Morrow doing her thing. She overextended.
4, 5.5, 5.5, 6.
guys and five girls diving, but only three are official. That's Reese doing a very high difficult degree of difficulty dive with two sevens and a seven and a half. And as the younger divers are learning, they'll clean up a lot of their dives. Muscle memory is the key to diving. If you know how to do the dive, you'll know how to do it for a long time as long as you are competing properly. Stouse is doing a back dive. Objective is to try to remain as close to the diving board as possible. Extending yourself out is the deduction, so you try to limit your space within the diving board and your entry into the water. Like those are fives. I was a little off.
Three, four, five, two, three, back, one.
officially the diving portion of the program will be 13 points to the boys and the girls. Good dive, right, Alyssa. You want to go ahead and give us the entries? And the girls are off. This is a seminal event right here, getting into the next process. Four laps of the pool, butterfly being the toughest unorthodox stroke. Uses a lot of upper body strength. If you notice how the girls are pulling their hips over their body with their shoulders. And fourth. So that's okay. Hopkinton will take unofficially 9 points to Norwell's 6 points. So Hopkinton has unofficially increased their lead by would be 10 points. 41-30. I apologize, 9-7, there was a, I didn't see the fifth place finisher, but 9-7, so they pick up a 2-point spread. So unofficially, they are up by nine. We're gonna do that one short again, 1, 3, and 5, because we're back. Somehow we have that off as our program has been given to us in a very simple manner, but not correct. And if this was the same dive, same swimmer that was doing the breaststroke and the IM, we're in for a quick finish. Not sure who he is, but he's got to be competing on the state level. Thank you. We'll get that soon enough from Mr. Franklin at the scorer's table. What do we have for the next event? Four laps of the pool, 25 yards. Back to 1, 3, and 5 again. And I believe we're going to have a number, we're going to have multiple heats. So sit back, ladies and gentlemen. This one's a sprint, four laps of the pool. Lydia Franklin in lane 3. Short lead ahead of Rachel, is it Rachel Zale in lane 5? Okay. Looks like Hopkinton's 1-2 coming down to the final. Hopkinton. Four and five for Norwell.
Okay, next up is the 500 freestyle. Oh, actually, we're going to have a couple of heats here.
We have the unofficial competitors. Hopkinton 1-2, 1-2-3. Gives the girls good experience, valuable experience. In the pool, the only way you're gonna get better is practice and competing.
girls are competing against themselves for time and to show Coach King that they're worthy of competing in a first heat. What do we have for the next meet, next event? Yeah, he might lap everybody at this point. Hopkinton's looking for a second and possibly fourth place finish. We're not sure about that, but at least a second place finish. What do we have for the next event?
The next event we have the 500 freestyle.
20 laps of the pool, 25 yards apiece. You'll see the competitors have a lane sign helper, which will give you the number that you are going forward as and you've completed, and you have to do 20 of them, and then you'll hear a bell or a buzzer for the final lap. Lydia's in lane three. Yep.
Anyway, we have Abby, Lydia, and as Russ mentioned, the other end of the pool, they do have people to help the swimmer keep in mind which lap they're on.
Actually, Lydia may be in lane one. I can't tell with the goggles. Either way, 1, 3, and 5 are Hopkinton swimmers.
Okay, looks like Hopkinton is down by 2 on the boys' side. I didn't catch the girls. Up 9.
This is definitely a marathon, so sit back. If you need to go to the bathroom, you won't miss much for the first 10 laps, so we hope you to get back for the final 10. Otherwise, 20 laps at 25 yards apiece.
The goal is anywhere between 5:30 and 5:45 to qualify for states as they run along, but you try to get a pace where you're comfortable with breathing properly and also stroking properly, and that's part of the key. If Hopkinton can place second, fourth, and fifth, they can nullify the first place finish of Norwell. I'm getting ahead of myself, but as I see, the Norwell girl is competing very strongly with a nice stroke. Should be free, because remember they just competed in, so I think the score is wrong on that one, because that was the last event, the 100 yard. Unless we're behind, but either way, it looks like we have a 9-point lead. Have another 7 laps plus to go. She's picking up some pace, but she's got to catch her. She only has 7 laps to go, so she's got to catch her. Put something together, otherwise. Gotta kick it eventually, though. There's only 3 laps to go. Just gotta pick it up. Okay, I'll take your word for it. was about that, but it's a two lapper. Looks like a first and third for Norwell. 9 points to Hopkinton, 7. So they'll lose 2 points on that. Yeah, negative 2. 2-4-5 for Hopkinton, 1-3 for Norwell. Tightened up the meet just a little bit. It looks like only two are competing though, two out of the four. Sure. Speed and he's gliding, look like he's got a good kick, he's gliding, he's not wasting energy. Well, if the Hopkinton boys can get 2 and 3, they can garner 7 points to Norwell's 8, so that's a close event. the Norwell young man is cruising along at his pace. Hopkinton's hoping to pick up second and third place. They're getting there, and then looks like Norwell may finish fourth along with first place. And Hopkinton's coming down the home stretch in lane five, completing it. Second place finish, all things considered, not a bad event. Giving it his effort. Absolutely a tough race. What do we have for the next event there, John? Looks like school record's already been broken. Last meet or the wheat meet before with Grace, Abigail, Olivia, and a Lamely Way. He's trying to mix it up a little, so we'll see how it competes from there. I know Coach King's methods. I'm believing that he thinks we're going to win this race because he doesn't have the school record holders in this race.
What's the time for winning time for the boys 500?
And having four girls swim 50 yards to give it her all is what that Coach King is asking for, and it looks like Hopkinton will take first as long as the next two competitors get off the blocks pretty well. And it's going to come down to the wire. It's going to be close, but it is close. And Hopkinton takes it. Ooh, that was close. That was like a razor's edge. Third.
How'd it go, Lydia?
No, only first and second. First, second, third is the place. So 10 points for the girls, 4 points for the other team. There might be another heat. Looks like the boys are going to compete. What do we have for the boys?
Okay, we got Paul Richardson, Jay Glover, Sam Richardson, Sam Cody, and also Justin Ford, Zach Glover.
Gotcha. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be interesting. Heavy hitters. And for those people that are interested in other sports, as we all are, we bid a fair adieu to Meadowlark Lemon today, former Harlem Globetrotter, and Dave Henderson, the individual who hit the two-run homer against Donnie Moore in the 86th League Championship Series.
That's just for people that are engaging in other sports besides swimming. And diving. The last competitor. What do we have for the next event? Junior. Yeah, Emily's in lane three, Julia's in lane one. I think Coach King knows he has this meet well in hand. Either the tabulations or putting a new girl in to compete, so he knows that it's pretty well in hand. She might have lost by a hair. Girls got two and three. And
in the gravity, you see the a lot of the teams out on the deck.
6, 3, and 1. 10 points for... Yes. 6, would they go 1, 3, and 4?
Yeah.
11 points. To Hopkinton's 5. So it looks like there's a 9-point lead after the relay. I think we have the breaststroke first.
Oh, sorry. Breaststroke, here we go. Tiana McCann, Mallory Pishoff, and Leah Yenemoyne.
Pressed. It's okay. Parts of the body. Two, we got 2, 4, and 5. 7 points to 9 points. So we lost 2 on that one, but I think it's well in hand. Probably going to put in some gross stuff. As long as they haven't gone, I believe, 4 events, I think he could. He was playing for the Red Sox. Then he got traded.
I know how that series ended.
We all do.
Of course, we wouldn't even talk about the 2000s.
But Dave Henderson in Red Sox lore is up there with Carlton Fisk in 1975.
Bernie Carbo. Johnny Damon.
Johnny Damon?
2004? Oh, no. It's home runs, though.
Home runs.
Okay. Dave Roberts. If Hopkinton can take 2, 3, and 4, they might stay within it and then deal with the relay at the end, but I don't know if they're going to be able to do it. Two, three, five for Hopkinton. Eight points, so it was a wash. And the last event of the evening is going to come down to the 100 yards per individual swimmer. We hope to see you back here on Wednesday. We have another home meet. I'd like to thank everybody who volunteered tonight. Scorekeepers, timers, parents, our trusted video people, and for the fans attending and cheering on the Hopkinton faithful. Well, Hopkinton boys, if we want to fast forward, we have to, I would presume we'll have to make first and third to compete for the final. So we'll see what happens there if they have 800-yard racers.
That's a fast swimmer in lane four. That's a fast swimmer. That's okay. Your daughter's doing okay. They had a couple nice anchors in that one. And if you take a look at the listing of the boys from Norwell, it looks like they have their heavy hitters in this one. Just from the structures of their bodies. Afraid to finalize everything. Yep. I think Dave's texting you.
He's still at the boys trailing Norwell at 200 feet. Although he's feverishly texting. Okay, so just to set it up again.
Doesn't look too good. there's Kenny Lowe when you need him. I don't know if he's. I'll leave that one for Al Campanis. No, I think we're on the southern end of that northerly fight. But it was a good effort. It shows that although the Norwell boys didn't have a volume of swimmers, each swimmer was very, very precise and very, very consistent. But can't take it away from the Hopkinton boys who gave their hearts out tonight. The Hopkinton girls, I don't know if they won going away, but apparently they won. And it's coming from an unofficial, but the girls win 92-89. The score is a lot closer than it really was. Norwell's going to finish 1-2. As there's still a loud ring, as I've discussed with my former partners before, the only thing left for the competitors after this last 25 yards is what they call the cheer. We'll see what type of cheer they give the Norwell visiting team. And that completes the diving swimming portion of our meet. We'd like to thank all of our sponsors tonight. We'd like to thank anybody who has made some voluntary donations, food, drink. Anybody have a cough drop? I would be grateful. We'll cross paths again. It was an honor to
co-host this event. We'd like to thank everybody for showing up. Drive carefully. Don't be disillusioned by the potential rain and snow tomorrow. Everybody drive very carefully. We're not in North Carolina. And potato chip, potato chip. Very fine bunch. And Ross Annenberg signing off for John. We hope you guys have a good night.